We want to determine if the two given functions are inverses of one another. Remember, inverse functions are two functions that undo each other. So to show if two functions are inverses of one another, we have to show that f of g of x is equal to x, and also that g of f of x is equal to x. This is a way of verifying that for every input, the two functions will undo each other. Notice here the initial input into g is x, and the final output of the composite function is also x. The input and the output are the same because the two functions undo each other in this direction. And also for g of f of x, the initial input into f is x, and the final output of the composite function is also x. Again, verifying that the two functions will undo each other because the initial input and the final output are both the same. So for f of g, we'll write f of g of x. And since g of x is the inner function, and g of x is equal to the quantity x plus 3 divided by 7, we'll have f of the quantity x plus 3 divided by 7. And this will become the input into function f, where f of x equals 7 times x minus 3. So this would be equal to 7. Now the input is this fraction, x plus 3 divided by 7 minus 3. And now we'll simplify. Notice here we can think of this as 7 over 1. So these 7s simplify to 1. So we'd have the quantity x plus 3 minus 3. So this composite function does equal x. So this is good news, but we also have to show that g of f of x is equal to x. So we'll go ahead and write this as g of f of x. Now notice the inner function is f of x, which is equal to 7x minus 3. So this is equal to g of 7x minus 3. So this becomes the input into function g. So we'll substitute 7x minus 3 for this x here. So we'll have 7x minus 3 plus 3, all divided by 7. If we simplify the numerator, notice how we have minus 3 plus 3, that's 0. So we have 7x all over 7, which does simplify to x. So g of x is also equal to x. Therefore, these two functions are inverses. Let's take a look at a second example now. Here, f of x equals x cubed minus 1, and g of x equals the cube root of x plus 1. Again, to verify that these are inverse functions, we must show that both of these composite functions are equal to x. So for f of g, we'll write this as f of g of x. Notice how the inner function is g of x, which is equal to the cube root of the quantity x plus 1. So we'll have f of the cube root of the quantity x plus 1. So all this becomes the input into function f, where f of x is equal to x cubed minus 1. So we're going to cube the input of the cube root of x plus 1, and then we'll subtract 1. Well, if we cube a cube root, these will undo each other, leaving us with the radicand of x plus 1. X plus 1 minus 1 is equal to x, so that's good news. The first composite function is equal to x. Now we need to verify that g of f is also equal to x. So we'll write g of f as g of f of x. Now the inner function is f, which is equal to x cubed minus 1. So this becomes g of x cubed minus 1. So all this becomes the input into function g, where g of x equals the cube root of the quantity x plus 1. So we're going to have the cube root. And then instead of x plus 1, we'll have x cubed minus 1 plus 1. Well, here notice how minus 1 plus 1 simplifies to 0. This is just the cube root of x cubed, which would be equal to x. And since both composite functions are equal to x, we have verified that these two functions are inverses of one another. So it is important that we show our detailed work here, because our work is our verification. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.